Today, we are going to discuss the topics of motivation, maintaining a positive attitude, and managing stress. Our participants are Akash, Ravi, Ritvi, Karan, and Aman. Let's start with Akash. Akash, can you explain what motivation is and the different types of motivation?
Sure. Motivation is what drives us to achieve our goals and complete tasks. There are two main types of motivation, intrinsic and extrinsic. Intrinsic motivation comes from within. It's when you do something because you find it personally rewarding. For example, studying a subject because you find it interesting. Extrinsic motivation, on the other hand, is driven by external rewards like money, grades, or praise. For instance, working hard to get a scholarship or a good grade.
Great explanation, Akash. Ravi, can you add to this and maybe give an example of each type of motivation?
Of course. For intrinsic motivation, think about someone who loves painting. They spend hours on it just because they enjoy the process and feel fulfilled. An example of extrinsic motivation would be a student studying hard for exams to win a prize or to avoid getting punished by their parents. Both types are important and can influence our behavior in different ways.
Thank you, Ravi. Now let's move on to maintaining a positive attitude. Ritvi, could you share some ways to maintain a positive attitude?
Definitely. Maintaining a positive attitude is crucial for our mental well-being. Some ways to stay positive include practicing gratitude, which means appreciating what you have instead of focusing on what you lack. Another way is to surround yourself with positive people who uplift and support you. Also, taking care of your health by exercising regularly and eating well can boost your mood. Lastly, setting realistic goals and celebrating small achievements can help maintain a positive outlook.
Excellent points, Ritvi. Karan, do you have any other tips on maintaining a positive attitude?
Yes, I think it's also important to engage in activities that you enjoy and that relax you. Hobbies like reading, playing sports, or listening to music can be great stress relievers and mood boosters. Additionally, positive self-talk, where you encourage yourself and stay optimistic even in tough situations, can make a big difference. It's about training your mind to see the good in every situation.
Very insightful, Karan. Now, let's discuss how to manage stress. Aman, what are some effective ways to handle stress?
Managing stress is essential for maintaining both mental and physical health. One effective method is practicing deep breathing or meditation, which can help calm your mind. Another way is to stay organized. Keeping a planner or to-do list can help you manage your time better and reduce the feeling of being overwhelmed. Physical activity is also a great stress buster. Whether it's a sport, yoga, or just a walk in the park, it can help clear your mind. Lastly, talking to someone you trust about your stress can be very helpful. Sharing your worries can make them seem less daunting.
Those are great strategies, Aman. Akash, do you have anything to add on stress management?
Yes, I think it's important to find balance in life. Don't overcommit to too many activities or responsibilities. It's okay to say no sometimes and prioritize what's truly important. Also, ensure you get enough sleep, as rest is crucial for stress management. And don't forget to take breaks and give yourself some downtime to recharge.
Wonderful contributions, everyone. To summarize, we have discussed the different types of motivation, ways to maintain a positive attitude, and various strategies to manage stress. These are important skills not just for students, but for life in general. Thank you all for your valuable insights. This concludes our group discussion.